I am excited to tell you about a new movie filmed right here in Wisconsin. It stars Wisconsin actors, and a local woman not only wrote it and produced it, she also stars in it.
You can work hard, but you can always work harder.
Wisconsin takes center stage, and Mags and Julie go on a road trip. Written, produced, and directed by 40-year-old Ryan Liebel. She also stars in the film as Mags.
I'm a little burnt out.
When was the last time you had a vacation?
Your wedding.
4 years ago.
When we went skiing.
6 years ago.
Mags and Julie is about two best friends. They haven't really spent much time together. My character, Mags, works a lot and maybe too much. And her friend, Julie, who is very bohemian and loves everybody and has a perfect marriage. Anyone who has ever worked for a horrible boss, anyone who has had things come up in their life that have been disasters and they've looked back on it and they've laughed because it was so ridiculous.
My grandfather left you a cabin in his will.
Cabin?
This is really for everyone. It's a family-friendly comedy.
Not only are you a young actress, but you're a producer, director, and writer. I mean, what can't you do, can I ask?
Before Liebel left for the bright lights of L.A., her talent was honed here.
I grew up in Cedarburg, Grafton. We were in Thiensville for a little bit, and then Mequon for a time. And wow. Then a bit of middle school and high school was Bayside. I was at Nicolet High School in Glendale. I had a great theater teacher there. I did some professional theater in Milwaukee. The Skylight Theater, did some stuff with the Rep. And then by the time I was 18, I went to USC in Los Angeles.
After majoring in theater, the actress landed jobs with Hollywood notables.
I worked with Dennis Farina years ago before he passed away. Tori Spelling, Zach Galifianakis. I worked with John Travolta. I did something with him that was super fun for his Be Cool movie. That was really fun. He was really lovely and took the time to say hello to me, and which was, I thought, was really nice.
Ryan was young when she saw the impact films could have.
The reason I started acting was because I had been highly influenced by movies when I was growing up. Movies that sort of showed me a viewpoint that I didn't have before. Showed me a world that I hadn't known existed.
Liebel, her musician husband, and son are like nomads. Her work with her production company, REL, takes her all over the country.
We're hardcore artists.
But extensive travel has not paved over her Wisconsin roots.
I wanted to highlight all of the beauty about Wisconsin, all of the characters who are here, and the kind of humor, too, which I think is pretty universal humor, which is that, I don't know, funny Wisconsin humor, right?
Yeah, a little self-deprecating, but it's honest.
Mags and Julie Go on a Road Trip was filmed entirely in Wisconsin and features Wisconsin actors.
Who would have thought I'd be in a movie, you know, at 65?
I wanted to do something that really highlighted Wisconsin in an interesting way. And as you know, we don't see Wisconsin on camera that often. It's not that typical. And to me, it's such a beautiful state full of such great people that I think it's nice to sort of show it, you know, in a cinematic way, because I think people in Wisconsin take Wisconsin for granted.
You are absolutely correct.
The tire blew.
There's no spare tire.
Hey, I'm Julie.
And Ryan Liebel wants her movies to leave people with positive messages, feeling a little better about the world in which we live.
I'm a firm believer in stories that have some sort of moral compass. I think that's something that kind of is lacking, you know?
I love that. I think it's very important. I really do, especially for our young kids.
I'm a huge believer that if you're going to make a movie, leave people better than you found them, you know? So when they walk out of the movie theater or they've just watched your movie, they feel better about life. They have a little bit of hope.
Are you excited about vacation?
Ah, yes, hope. And one of the other main characters in the movie is Wes Tank. Now, we have also featured him on Positively Milwaukee for his Dr. Seuss and Story Raps videos.
I think it's it's a really good family-friendly film.
And you might have noticed also in the movie, Milwaukee native and former executive director for Mad Hot Ballroom, Deborah Ferris. She was also featured on Positively Milwaukee. This film is available for pre-order on iTunes, Apple.com. The movie will be on all streaming services and Redbox November 24. So I think Wisconsinites, we will love to see that.